feeling it, man.
Feeling it. Feeling it. Feel the energy.
Following critical acclaim for their last album, the first together in 10 years, Madness have become one of the stars of the festival season. This audience is waiting for the band's first ever appearance at Tea in the Park, Scotland's biggest music event.
Calm before the storm.
Really deviated from what we started out to do, which was to try and write great songs and also to have a kind of set live that makes people feel like they want to jump up and down and have a good time. I think, intriguing for young people to come and see this strange edifice. We've been going 30 years and rock and roll's only been going for 50 years. And, you know, there was no blueprint, was there? I mean, I used to look at the Rolling Stones when they're sort of in their mid-30s, thinking, look at them old, sad old monkeys still trying to pretend they're 18.
Yeah.
You know, and then, and then they've got their 50s and their 60s, you know. But I think there are cycles, certainly with us. It seems to be sort of almost every 10 years, you know, you just keep going and eventually people come round to your way of thinking.
Back in the olden days, Buster, he sound the heat with a rock steady beat. And I'm confused, erupting about not in our street. I go some six preparing. You gotta help me swim your feet. Cause if you're not in the mood to dance, we'll step back, grab yourself a seat. This is where I'm from, uptown Jamaica, but we promise you a treat. We're a person when we ever win your focus dance, shove me up my feet. Even if I kept on running, I'd never get to out in the street. So I said there's nothing left to say for the man who set the beat. So I leave it up to you, I know, to get him back on his feet, yeah. Yeah.
I'm running. I never get to own the street now. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and you, sir, those of you of a nervous disposition, make your way quietly to the back of the county. Be afraid, be very afraid. In the blue corner, weighing in at 240 kilograms.
Barzo, where are we, mate? We're lost. Come on. You understand all this modern young stuff?
King Tut's Wild Wild Park. That must be it, no?
I'd like to introduce you to the most intelligent, richest man in the band, Monsieur Barzo. When we started the band, we used to rehearse in his bedroom. And he was playing this song. Let's be perfectly frank, he doesn't like me to say this, right? But he was delivering bananas. He was in a banana delivery van. And he said, Suggs, I've written this song, what do you think? I said, it's all right. I didn't want to see the film tonight. I found it hard to say. She thought I'd had enough of her. Why can't she say? She's lovely to me, aye aye. But I like to stay in and watch TV on my own every now and then. My girl's mad at me. Been on the telephone for an hour and we hardly said a word. I tried to...
In the live shows, we do classic 3-minute pop songs that people enjoy. I think we've put ourselves in the position of an audience. What would we want if we went to a gig?
Embarrassment. We had this sort of notion of doing English Motown. I think it was Elvis Costello said, you know, the great thing about British pop bands is they take black American music and get it slightly wrong. And it's sort of true, isn't it?
It is.
Especially for us. And so Yeah, we had this sort of Motowny kind of riff, which was Mike's tune, and Lee wrote some words about his sister who'd had a baby with a black guy, and there was some consternation in the family and with some of his friends. Because, you know, we're talking about a long, long time ago, and it was, you know, there were strange things going on. There was Alf Garnett on the telly and all that. And it was a very serious song about a serious thing, which, you know, you see these kids now all grown up, you know, at the time, imagine being castigated by your own families. Again, it's one of those funny madness things where we, you know, we were talking about serious things, but, you know, with the clown's noses on. One of my favourite songs, actually.
Can I just... I've got a little story about embarrassment. It's fantastic. There was a programme called Round Table on the BBC years ago, and they used to review singles, and Mark Knopfler was on that week. And
Mark Knopfler?
Knopfler. And, yes, he said of embarrassment that it wasn't good English and it didn't scam properly. I think he just completely missed the point.
Some of his ways, he just can't be known.
each person in the band sort of brings their own sound to it, and that conglomerate of input becomes a sort of madness track, you know?
Particularly with keyboards, sax and vocals, I suppose, more so.
Yeah.
Because they're the predominant.
Yeah, sure. Not all the instruments. Maybe we could get another drummer.
This is a song about friendship. I tell you one thing, much as I've had some ups and downs with these characters, the last 30 years...
He's fucking talking.
30 years. You cannot make any new old friends.
I mean, we started out as friends, and the whole raison d'etre for the band was just something to do as a group of friends.
Being mates is sort of, you know, is like the glue behind the band, I think, yeah. Which makes it all possible, you know.
It takes a long time for people to get, you know, in our little inner circle, and it is a gang of mates that really know each other very well. No one else can see. It's all a hazy dream. I remember them summer days when we took whatever came our way. We got away, hey, but not too far. We took this.
You know, we have a very strict barometer, and if the song doesn't go down well, I mean, certain members of the band will keep trying to force one of his songs without mentioning any names, Mike Barson. In the end, if the audience don't like it, then we have to stop playing it, and it's as simple as that. So I think we've got a good mixture, yeah, of old and new. No!
Thank you very much.
One more time.
1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you very much. Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias.
Muy bien.
What a great joy it is to be back in Scotland, man. Oh, yes.
Come on, you bastards, oh, yes. Come on! Tear a piece of my fucking door, you
and
would.
For those of you who aren't aware, completely, we are madness.
NW5 was one of the first off the new album that we did, and the more we played it live, the more it seemed to fit in.
A very strange disguise, and though you have become a burden, certain I will love you all my life. But without you in my life.
With those new songs in there, it gives us a bit of freshness and it makes the whole thing worthwhile. It really does. I mean, we had to start doing some new stuff. Just seems like an old Madness classic. You know, what we've been doing for years. In fact, we have been doing it.
It is
years.
Old Madness. Fantastic.
Yeah, we have. Years. Yeah, it's about. Yeah, we know how to play it now.
Witness the blessing rise up in a very strange disguise, and nothing seems last forever, and people change just like the weather. Some for good, and sometimes never. Appreciate. I'd like to play for you now a song about not getting bitter and twisted when you get old, as we are old, but we're not bitter and twisted.
No, only a little bit.
Stay forever see the freshness in your young face. It's like a candle in the gloom, and the brightness in your smiling eyes. Well, they're lighting up the room, the field, the planet, the whole world, the whole universe, the whole universe. Oh, say forever young, don't you do
House came from the album The Rise and Fall, I believe, and we, as a project to each other, said let's have a subject that we can all write songs about, and it was all about childhood. And that was a simple task, that everyone should be go away and write about their childhood. So Mike went away and wrote about New Delhi, which was completely no. Anyway, Carl came up with the lyrics to Our House, you know, which is all about him growing up in his house and street that he lived in and all the characters around. And Chris just happened to have a bit of tasty music, and we did our typical madness going into the studio. Was no really thinking about it, apart from it was just one of the tracks on the Rise and Fall album.
She needs a rest. The kids are playing up downstairs. Sister's selling you.
got a date to keep. He can't hang around. Thank you very much. Understood. 60 big boy, a 4 point in my manhood. I'm up too late to the next 2 days. Try the house of fun. It's quicker if you run. This is a chemist, not a junk shop. Party hats, simple enough beer. We'll comprehend this and we understand. What do you hear? A pack of party hats with their colour tips. Too late, I go to circus. Yeah, well, 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 well. Hello, Joe, hello, Miss Clay. And it returns from the dead. Welcome to the house of fun. Now I've come on page. Welcome to the house. Ladies. Oh. Thank you, ladies.
For the wings of a dove.
One more thing to say to yous. Love, love, so much without words. Well, bless you and bless me. Bless the bees and the birds. Yes, fellas, especially the birds. Got to be near you every night, every day. I couldn't be happy any other way. It must be love, love, love. It must be love, love, love. Nothing more, nothing less. Love is the best, yes, yes, yes. Thank you very much indeed. Sometimes it's a pleasure. Sometimes it's a privilege. And every now and then it's a pleasure and a fucking privilege. Thank you.
Tyson's
right.